There are some considerations to take into account when you're developing an architecture or a topology for ACE. If you remember early on in the class, we talked about the components of ACE, those components being the ACE manager, the ACE wizard, and the ACE scheduler. Now, there's also, you might consider a fourth component, and that might be the module database structure that's holding the ACE configuration. And in fact, where most people have these applications installed on their Pi servers, there are quite a number of different considerations or different configurations that you can take advantage of. Also keep in mind that the ACE calculations, the DLLs and the executables, they do require resources. They do require CPU time. They do require memory. And so you may, if you have a lot of ACE calculations, you may want to think of hosting them on a machine that's other than your Pi server. Also, when you're developing your executables, you may want to consider grouping modules and contexts or calculations under individual executables based on the number of resources or the amount of time that each one of those executables is going to require in order to do its job. For example, if you have five calculations that are very quick, they don't require much resources at all, and you have a sixth calculation that requires a lot of resources and does take a while to run through, you may want to group the five quick calculations under one executable as modules and have the long calculation its own executable, thereby having to gather and have its own resources for that specific calculation. And remember, everything that you have, all the configuration information, everything is stored in a Pi module database. When people set up ACE, as we said earlier, a lot of times they'll just load everything on the Pi server. And in fact, that's what we do in the classroom. We take the Pi server and we install the wizard, the ACE manager, and the ACE scheduler on the student's Pi server. And that has access also to the module database structure on that server as well. That ACE machine or Pi server with ACE on it can then read from and write to any other Pi server that it has, that it can see across the network, that it has access to. And there is an advantage to this configuration, in fact, is speed. Everything's all in one machine, and there's no need to have any network communications between the actual engine and the Pi server or the manager and the engine or whatever. It does have the disadvantage, however, of competing for resources. Remember, every ACE executable or DLL, it does require its own CPU time and memory. And so you can run into situations where there's a problem when you have a Pi server that's got a lot of tags or involved in a lot of data collection and an ACE structure that's trying to do a lot of calculations. Very often what people will do is they will segment the applications that are associated with ACE off onto what we refer to as an ACE server. And this is simply a computer that's not the Pi server. Of course, there will still have to be one module database structure at least to hold the configuration, but the ACE manager, wizard, and scheduler are all installed and run on a separate server. This does have the advantage of not competing for resources with the Pi server itself, but it does have the disadvantage of having to communicate across a network. There's also another permutation of this where you install the ACE components on an ACE server with the exception of the ACE wizard. So you would have the ACE manager and scheduler and then the completed DLLs and executables running on an ACE server, communicating with at least one Pi server for the module database structure and other servers for data. And the ACE wizard would be deployed on a separate box. This might be an engineer's or technician's workstation. It might be someone's laptop. It doesn't really matter where you run this, as long as you have the development environment and that computer can see the same Pi server that holds the module database structure and has the appropriate permissions, we'll talk about that later, on that server, as does the ACE box. That way you can code compile and test ACE calculations on the development box, and when they're all set and ready to go, you simply copy the DLLs and executables off to the ACE server and run them there using the ACE manager. So that's a variation on the ACE server installation. Again, it has the advantages of not competing for resources between the development environment and the ACE stuff or the Pi server. And you don't have to have the development environment loaded on either of the servers. However, you do have the network considerations to take into account.